Alyssa, I want to spread the gospel, but I don't know how, because if I do, they're going to say that I'm forcing my religion on them. So what do I do? This is a good way, okay? If you're anything like me, you're friends, or you guys obviously have a lot of talks on FaceTime, and you guys talk about life and blah, blah, blah. So literally just ask them, be like, dude, I'm curious, what do you believe in? Like, what do you think is the meaning of life? Let them talk first. Let them talk for hours if they want to. And listen to them. Don't go, pfft, or all of this stuff. Listen. Then, when they're done, say whatever you need to say, and then be like, this is what I believe in. And if they already know what you believe in, which they should if you're Christian, be like, oh, okay, yeah, I get it, or whatever. And then be like, okay, this is why I believe in God. And then spread the gospel. And then you can add, like, all of these, like cool facts and, like, your experience with it. And then you can go off. Because then it doesn't come off as harsh. And it's, like, more of a conversation rather than you trying to drill something into their head. There you go. It started with the hay. Lost a creek and well, it just started in the hay.
With his long johns on, pop went a creeping up to the bottom to the hay. Well, do I have a story for you? When I was a sophomore in college, I learned how important it is that our prayers are bold and specific. So, sophomore year of college, I get to room with my best friend in the whole world, and we both love Jesus a ton, and we prayed that God would give us someone we could really love and minister to. Well, 3 weeks late into the semester, this girl shows up to be our third roommate, and she is from China, speaks no English, is 17, and like fresh out of high school. And she uses Google Translate to tell us, night one, she's not a Christian. So we become friends with her through Google Translate. We talk every day. Me and my roommate are continuously praying for this girl. And one day she comes home crying, only to reveal through Google Translate that her sponsor was trying to blackmail her. So she has to cut off her sponsor, but she's scared they're gonna send her home because she's got no money and no potential sponsors to stay in school. So we get a whole group together without her knowing, and we pray that they would let her stay, and she has her meeting, and for some reason, they let her stay at school. So then, it gets crazier. Part two coming. So our college lets our roommate stay and even finds her another sponsor. So then our next prayer is that we'd have a Mandarin Bible. That comes a few weeks later. She starts reading it and she's like, did you know God created the world? And we're like, yes. But she starts in Genesis, so she's a long way from Jesus. So we start praying that God would send us someone who knows Mandarin to share the actual gospel. We meet this girl out of nowhere, super crazy circumstance, don't have time to get into it in a 1 minute video. But that girl starts to meet with her for lunch and she starts coming home and she's like, did you know God had a son? We're stoked, right? So we're still praying, and months later, we sit on the couch, and she just goes, you know, I think God loves me. And we're like, really? Why? And she's like, I prayed I would understand my professor better, and today, I did. And I'm like, oh my gosh, he does love you. And I share all these specific prayers me and my roommate had been praying for her, and she starts to cry, and she's like, God really does love me. He answers my prayers. He loves me, and gives her life to Jesus right then and there after months of
Why do girls always have to get into toxic relationships? Like, y'all are looking into the wrong Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Okay, these are the men you need in your life right now. They will never leave you unread. You read them, okay? Now, get them together.
It started with the hay, lost a creek and well, it just started in the hay. With his long johns on, pop went.
Be gracious to me, Lord, because I am in distress. My eyes are worn out from frustration, my whole being as well. Indeed, my life is consumed with grief and my years with groaning. My strength has failed because of my iniquity, and my bones waste away. I am ridiculed by all my adversaries and even by my neighbors. I am dreaded by my acquaintances. Those who see me in the street run from me. I am forgotten, gone from memory like a dead person, like broken pottery. I have heard the gossip of many. Terror is on every side. When they conspired against me, they plotted to take my life. But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God. The course of my life is in your power. Rescue me from the power of my enemies. Speak this passage over your life today, because if the Lord is for you, who can be against you? Give thanks in sorrow.
Proof of God, Part 7. Sodom and Gomorrah. We read about these two cities within the book of Genesis. And in scripture, it records the exact method God used to wipe out these two cities. It is recorded that God rained down burning sulfur upon the cities to destroy them. What is fascinating is that if you go to Sodom and Gomorrah today, you will find remains of burnt sulfur balls in the walls. These aren't any ordinary sulfur balls. These are sulfur balls with burnt exteriors, meaning that they were all inflamed at one point in time. This discovery has shocked many scientists as they have no explanation on why there are burnt sulfur balls in the walls of the city. What's more is that the walls of the city have been warped by extreme heat, and they are literally ashen remains. Scientists and archaeologists alike are perplexed on this discovery. There are over 30,000 archaeological discoveries which verify scripture. Stay tuned.
Deaths that changed history forever.
Excuse me, is that a Bible you got there? Yeah, why? Please stop forcing your religion and put the Bible away. You're making a lot of us uncomfortable. Miss, I'm here by myself reading my Bible. I'm not bothering anyone, nor am I forcing my religion. Aren't you supposed to love your neighbors? Miss, I am not bothering anybody. What is going on?
This is why I hate Christians. I don't care what the Bible says. I don't care what you have to say. Just stop forcing your religion. Hi, yes, there's somebody here that I've asked to leave multiple times because they are forcing their religion down everybody's throats and making a lot of us here in the library uncomfortable.
You know what, I'm just gonna leave and I'm gonna make sure to pray for you, okay?
No, please don't pray for me. Keep my name out your mouth. I don't believe in prayer. Stop forcing your religion.
So I wanted to share a quick story with you guys. I don't do this, and I normally don't share about Jesus on TikTok, but I feel like it's time because this is just too crazy. I was at a Korean barbecue place the other day in Texas, and we had this wonderful waitress who was so kind to us. And I asked my two friends to pray before we left to see if Jesus had anything to say to her. I truly believe that we were made with such closeness to Jesus that we can hear him in our own thoughts. And so I heard the Lord say that she had a sister who died. And I was like, there's no way I'm asking that, and that's definitely not true anyways. So as I approached the girl, I just hear the Lord say again in my head, in my own thoughts, that she has a sister who's sick. So I just went with it and I said, hey, do you have a sister? And she goes, yes. And I was like, is she sick right now? And she looks at me in awe and she says, how do you know that she has COVID and it's bad? I said, I'm a Christian and I love Jesus and I believe that he speaks to us about other people to encourage them. And then she told me she had a sister who died a year ago. And she started weeping in the middle of the Korean barbecue place in the middle of her shift. She looks at me and she says, how do you know that? And I said, I didn't, but Jesus does. And he loves you and he died on the cross for you and he was thinking of you on the cross. So we had to pray for her and tell her about the Lord.
This is what actually happens at a Christian college.
So I know everyone's finding out that I'm a Christian, so I just wanted to tell you guys why I believe in Jesus. In short, I grew up my whole life where my dad was atheist and my mom was a believer, and so I never actually knew what truth was. Both my parents would say I'm getting brainwashed from either side. And so when I was 19, I decided I need to find out what truth is, otherwise I could possibly waste my whole life. But I ended up going on like a 2-year adventure around the world discovering if Jesus was real. I researched everything from the resurrection to if prayer actually works. I dove into Buddhism, Islam, Mormonism, and Judaism, just searching for truth. But when I landed on the Bible and Jesus, I began to see things in my life actually change. And I don't say this to be cheesy, and I'm not trying to be cheesy at all, but like, I found actual freedom from like depression and anxiety and loneliness. And since choosing Jesus about 3 years ago, my life has like never been the same. Even in times of suffering, I still get to choose joy because I have Jesus. It's not a religious thing. It's having a relationship with the creator of the universe.
And it's so fun.
I look so good.
If you were in a coma, what's the one song that could literally wake you up?